Morning. So, some lintels arrived. 22 October. So today the bricks will arrive. I'm gonna prepare some things, make some samples from different bonds, set some profiles, and set out some levels. So then we can have a good start when the guys are here. First I'll move this shit to on the side, because I suspect the truck will come with a big trailer with all the bricks, eh? So yeah, let's do this first. So some windows they will install first, eh? Which makes my job more awkward. That's one. Two, I already know the gauge actually, because I calculated. My gauge is actually 5.84. So if you have a window, and this level of my window is exactly a brick, huh? Like that. And I know, so here are bricks also. I know the height of my window is 2.80 meters. My bricks are a thin joint brickwork. My joint is, I take a joint from 5 millimeter. 5 millimeter. So actually my course is 297.5. Till the joint. 297.5 centimeter divided by five. My course is 5.5, eh? Because the brick is 5. Is 51 courses. See, 51 courses. 51 courses. So if I do 297.5 divided by 51 is 5.48. So my joints are 5.48, and actually my last course is actually 5.5, just where the window is. So that's 0.2 millimeter. We're not gonna see that, huh? Okay, so this is how I calculated my gauge of my brickwork. It's calculated with the height of this window actually, because I can't change the height of the window, because the window are already in production. So cannot change this. I already made myself a gauge. It's right here. It says tin bed. Normally I cut these gauges in my ruler with a metal saw blade. But now I just carved it in with a Stanley knife. I just put my square against the meter and I carved it in with my Stanley knife, just to be more accurate, because it's 5.48 each gauge. 5.48, 10 gauges are 54.8, so that's 10 gauges. I have a measure stick. My measure stick is 2 meter long. Okay, so this tool is actually, for me, it's the best gauge stick you can have. I will show you later why. Let's release this clamp. Well, two options here. This is too difficult. first option is that. So 45 25, that 25 looks so small. Yeah, it's 25. Okay, here is 45, put here, clamp. That's that. You can move it. The line is here for my 45. There. That's one. So here the wall is 25. I mark 25 on my corner. Just gonna put it there. Let's fix it with this clamp. This line. I take a bit plus for the thickness of the line, and then a small distance from the line to your brickwork. Let's take it up here. Something like that. We're still gonna need to tweak it. Okay. So now we can plumb it. I explained many times already, I work with the 1 meter level, which means this level is 1 meter above the finished floor, which means if I want to know where my finished floor is, I can measure down, 1 meter down, here is my finished floor, and that's correct because I made my DBC. That's correct because I put my DBC on plus 1 centimeter. So this is 1 centimeter. So this is correct. This meter level, I'm gonna set on the profiles that I have put. Let's take this level, put it here. Here actually, it's possible, yes. It's there. This 1 meter level. Now, as we know, the brickwork starts on level 0, right? 0, I don't know, depends how deep your foundation is. Let's say this is your foundation, brickwork starts on 0. I don't know, in Belgium it's like that. For example, if you have a threshold or a stone on the front door, a bull stone or something, it's also on 0, eh? Yeah, like that. Now we come to my gauge stick that I have made. I know 1 meter down is the level of my floor and the level of my course. 1 meter down. So I just take 1 meter on my gauge stick, it's here. I put it on the meter level. It's here. 1 meter on my meter level. So now I know where my brickwork is. It's just right here on the 0. there. And my gauges, I can start gauging. I can go to all the way up. Voila. So now I still need to gauge down. This is zero. Let's say the terrace is on minus 20. We can gauge down, downwards. 20 is this here. So my first block here is like a concrete block. Then I know how big my concrete block needs to be. Voila. So this is how we set profiles, gauge the courses like that, which means one, it's more accurate because you can set pretty easy this level everywhere. And you can measure from this level to your first course down. It's practically, it's more easy. Like that. Second, if you need to continue somewhere with the gauges, you can just measure the difference between your meter level and your gauge here. Let's say it's 4.2. Okay? So I can go to every level on my profile, put my ruler on the meter level and measure 4.2 up and start gauging like that. So this is, yeah, basically the way how I work. So I get a lot of questions from people or comments why I don't build leads, like a 3-course lead. Well, because I think it's a waste. Every brick you need to level, every brick you need to gauge, you need to do it everywhere. And afterwards, when you have your leads, you will set a profile anyways. So why not set a profile directly, save the time and start accurately like this. I would use these Dutch pin clamps that we all know. It's much faster, but since we are gluing, I don't have a good joint to put it in, so don't use it. I use my clamps again. Bum bum bum. So it's here like that. So this is the thickness of my profile. Here is the wall. So let's fix this. Should be. Like that. The 5 is here. Okay, that's plumb. That's still good. Okay, so we need 45 here around. 45.3. 45 actually. So I can put my level again on this profile. Take my gauge stick, I can gauge it all till all the way up if I want.
was good. Like that. So, first course, it's right here. So, I got a little issue here. I prefer these profiles out of wood. Way more options to fix, but it's a bit too big. Pipe is in the way. I don't want to cut it now. So maybe this is 9. The aluminium profile is 6.5. So that's clamp. I mark the line here. Something like that. So this is plumb. That's great. That's great. This side, almost. Like that. So I can fix this clamp. I mean this Dutch pin. Like that. Let's check it again. It's plumb. Plumb. Little bit off. Voila. So this can stay here till we're there with the brickwork. Yeah? Level, gauges, line. That's fast.
Well, well, well. The bricks arrived. Better late than not. It's the end of the day. That guy can drive, because these are not easy turns to make backwards. I can drive, seriously. Oh! In één keer, klap gereden, maar met een frak.
Ja, er zijn gemakkelijker hier rieten.
Normally, to calculate the course, I take 10 bricks. I measure 10 bricks. Then I add 10 times the joint. So if you have a joint from 1.2, you add 12 centimeter and you divide it by 10. That's your average course, actually. But since I'm stuck with the window, I have a fixed course. I already calculated. It's 5.48. It's these courses here. So it's here. Ooh. Don't have much room to play, huh? Something like that is justly. We're lucky. Let's say if the brick was 1 millimeter bigger, I would have a problem. They picked it up in Holland. It's made in Holland, this one. I think it also has some Belgian factories, but I'm not 100% sure. The bricks are from Van der Sanden. Brilliant zwart impression means brilliant black impression. I haven't worked with this size yet. Bricks are 29 instead of 19. 9, so that's good. So when I have some profiles, I just hang the line and see what we have, eh? So I can just use my line pin. Go around the profile and stick it in there. It will stay. Should have 2 centimeters. Almost 2. So I move a bit. Okay. Oh boy, I was just thinking of something, because with the glue I'm gonna pick and dip, but these bricks are so long. So obviously there is only one way to make these bricks, eh? This side is the back side, it's no good. I can tell you already, this side is the line side, is to the line. That side is a downside, because it has a bubble here. You're not gonna place it like this, eh? Please put them like this, eh?